When China's Chang'e 5 mission returned with samples from the moon, most people expected, well, dirt, lunar dirt, great for science, not exactly headline material. But hidden in that gray dust were millions of tiny, round, shimmering particles, glass beads. They looked like cosmic pearls forged in fire, cooled in silence, and left untouched for billions of years. Then came the surprise. They contain water. Not moisture, not traces, actual extractable water. Meaning these unassuming grains of space glass may be the moon's invisible reservoirs, up to 270 billion tons. But here's the twist. Water is just the beginning. These beads are formed by intense lunar meteorite impacts. Imagine a high-speed space rock slamming into the moon, melting the surface and trapping minerals and gases into tiny, perfect spheres. They've been absorbing hydrogen from the solar wind ever since, creating those precious H2O molecules. So yes, water is in there. But also, clues to moon's volcanic past, records of solar activity, and possibly hints of extraterrestrial life. A groundbreaking study has demonstrated that volcanic glass played an important role in the origin of life by promoting RNA synthesis. On Earth, ancient volcanic glass has preserved microbes from millions of years ago. Who's to say that somewhere out there, similar beads might hold traces of early Martian biology? Which brings us to a bigger point. These glass structures aren't unique to the moon. Yes, impact glass has been discovered on Mars. They likely exist on Vesta, Ceres, and even large asteroids throughout the solar system, anywhere lacking an atmosphere and subject to violent impacts and volcanic events. But wait, there's more. Because these beads could also be the raw materials for building future space settlements. Their stable structure and low thermal conductivity make them ideal insulating material and armor layer. High silica beads can be used for 3D printing habitats. The insulating properties make them perfect for radiation shielding. Some contain iron, magnesium, even rare earths, perfect for in situ resource extraction into alloys or ceramics. So the next time you hear space economy, think beyond rockets and satellites. Lunar glass, Martian glass, asteroid glass. Imagine a future where the first bricks of a moon base come from sand, where the next energy revolution is powered by materials born in meteor fire, where water, minerals, even helium-3, all come embedded in sparkling grains of alien glass. Some might say this is a bit much for a bunch of glorified sand, but hey, sand built all of human civilization, do you know? Sand is the most natural resource consumed by humans besides water. Now, tiny glass beads from beyond Earth may build the next one. See you next time.